Good afternoon, folks. This is Nick Stoll here with Stoll's Outdoor, and I'm going to show you my buck saw today and what it's capable of doing. So first we'll just untie these little strings I got holding it together. String here, remove that. The way I designed this buck saw, okay, is so that the blade is folded up into the handle. See that? And it folds up from the bottom. That way the teeth are protected and covered. Okay, the blade's protected and you're protected from this. Then it folds out like that. Take the crossbar, it has a tenon on it, and you put it into the mortise on each side like that. Take your string, you put in these little notches on each side. Okay, and just take the little tensioner, the little deal right here, and start twisting it up so it's tight. Real easy system, guys. This particular saw right here is my first prototype. Okay, this is not the ones I sell. This is just my first prototype, my first functioning prototype. Okay, when I came up with this new design. So it's not perfect, but it's good enough for me. This will work really good for me, okay? But really, you know, the way I built the saw has nothing to do with its cutting capabilities. So all the cutting capabilities are right here in this blade, okay? This is the Bucksaw 24-inch dry wood cutting blade, okay? It's not the typical pruning blade that you get. The pruning blade has a lot larger rakers on it, larger teeth. And it's used for quickly pruning green wood. This one is made for cutting dry wood. Alright, now it cuts green wood very, very well. But this is made for dry wood. Let's see what it does with this piece of wood behind me here. This is bone dry wood. Okay, let's see how it does. This is not quite wrist size, but we'll get there. Okay, one, two. Look at that. That's dry. That is dry hardwood right there. Cut through it like nothing. Okay? Look at that. There's my thumb. I'd say that's about 2 inches in diameter. Okay, it's over an inch and a half, I know that. I'd say that's about 2 inches diameter. Now, I didn't count how many strokes that was. I know it was a little bit more than 10, but not much. Okay. Now, with the buck saw, unlike the folding saws, you're not pushing down with the blade, okay? You don't have to, you're not pushing down on the wood. All you're doing is letting the weight of the saw, okay, be the downward pressure on it. So just let the saw rest on the wood, and all you gotta do is go back and forth on it like that. Okay? Do a couple more. further up I get on that branch, you know, the bigger diameter it gets. But look at that. Look at those cuts. Okay, you can see that is dry hardwood right there, okay? Not sure what exactly that is. Okay, that is dry hardwood right there, and this saw is just eating it like it's its lunch. Little limbs right here. Nothing. You have to be careful on these little limbs. You don't want the saw to bounce. You get your hand, because that it will do that. It will jump and get your hand. You will have a very nasty cut. Anyway, showed you a little bit of that. Let me get set up here and we'll show you some more stuff, all right? Stay with me. Show you guys something else here. This is my Gransfors Brooks Hunter's Axe. Very nice axe, very sharp. Okay, just to show you how hard this wood is behind me, we're gonna chop on it with this just a little bit, okay? Alright, that's no sissy log, guys. Look at that. I'd say, well, we'll measure it with something we all wrap five. Okay, that's real close. 4.5 inches diameter, okay? Took a little bit of work with that little axe. See if the saw can do it without getting me winded. I think that was less time, folks. I think that was a lot less time than me messing with the axe. Now, I'm not claiming to be an axe guy. I'm not a professional axe swinger or anything. I'm just a typical everyday woodsman. Okay? That was a lot faster, I think. Alright, that's what this saw is designed to do. It's a buck saw. It's designed to buck up firewood. Okay, that is some hard wood too. Alright. Let's do one more just for science. There's my tape measure again. So, I'm gonna say that's right at or real close to 5 inches, depends on where you measure with the blade. Okay. Nice. That's some firewood there, boys. All right, stay with me, I'll see what else I can do for you. You're out in the woods. Cutting some firewood down. You really want to get all these obstacles out of your way. Alright. Last thing you want is a trip hazard, okay, while you're cutting or using a cutting tool, okay? Alright, it's a saw. As I've told people in woodworking, if it'll cut wood, it'll cut you, no question about it, okay? Little trick I learned over the years, cutting stuff, especially when it's not real stable like this log. You can see it kind of bouncing. Alright, little safety thing. Alright, some people might think it's a little bit weird, but trust me, it's safer to do it this way. Typically, you put your hand right here and cut with the saw, okay? That is not the safe way to do it. Okay, what happens is the saw can bounce. If you're doing it on a push stroke or a pull stroke, one or the other, and you have your hand right here and it bounces, and you carry on pushing, you're going to go right through your hand. That would be a nasty, nasty cut. Okay, so we don't want to do that. So what we'll do to start off with is we're going to put our hand through the saw. Okay, we're going to stabilize our work piece with this hand. Our arm is through the saw to start out with, okay? So that way if it bucks, it's not going anywhere. The only thing that's hitting us is the backside of this saw. That's not going to hurt you. So, we'll start out. Okay, got the blade in there a little ways. Check out now, guys. Look at that. That's some heavy, hard firewood right there. Okay, this is probably about as big as you'd need for a camp. Even this, you're probably going to split down for your campfire. Okay, that's some pretty big wood for a little saw. Alright, more than enough what you're going to use for just a typical camp out. But some people like to get out here and split firewood, so we cut more wood. Another one. Anyway, appreciate you for watching this, guys. And you know, this isn't just for cutting firewood. You can cut logs, or you know, camp furniture, everything else. It's just a real handy piece of equipment to have with you. I carry this. I also carry a Bucksaw folding saw. You know, doing little small notches where I don't want all this in the way when I'm just doing intricate carving work. This will do if this is all you have. Anyway, thanks for watching, folks, and I'll see you on the next one. This is Nick with Stowells Outdoor.